Dan here, DU Speed Shop. So, I think it's gonna rain. I just got home from work. Didn't quite get out early at all. Stole a tire off the Nomad. Man, that poor car's just getting parted out. It looks sad. Anywho, because Danny doesn't wanna go with me, hit the road. Took a thing to work today, did good. Actually, I got stuck in a pile of traffic on the way home, so it sat idling for like a half an hour and did good, but it is completely out of fuel. It seems to go through a fair bit of it.
It's not that I don't want to go with you. I just have other things I have to do.
You just don't like Josh and Dallas?
No, I love Josh and Dallas. I just have to
from a distance
the home for something.
Oh, yeah. So anyway, yeah, I don't know. Give once over, the belt kind of squeals a little bit. Yeah, I'll tighten that on the way or not. And yeah, I checked the oil and everything yesterday, so I'm sure it's fine today. Jamming that big tire in there was a bit of a hassle, but we got her in. So all that's in the trunk right now is tires, a bag of stuff, and I tossed the miscellaneous whatever. So hit the fuel station and on the road. I don't know if I'll make it the whole way tonight because I don't want to be driving in the dark, in the rain. So I might make it, you know, 2/3 of the way or something like that, get a hotel and go the rest of the morning.
I'm going to the movies tonight, so you'll have to book your own hotel room.
Lucky me. Anyways, you can't drive a 55 Chevy like this on the highway. Let's see if they're right. All right. Oh, garbage. We're like 2 hours into the trip, and I need this and this. Oh no, the rags. Man, I'm really not used to filming here without Danny. So, this thing is a bit of a hassle. When you have a one-man operation, you have to kind of do that. And then, I actually probably need two hands, but otherwise, this gets caught. Hang on. So we got actually overfilled the fuel just a little bit there, but basically I got 11 miles to the gallon, which I wouldn't say is fantastic. Hang on, I'll do that. But 11 and a half. What do you got going on there? Nothing looks too crazy. We have a bit of a coolant leak. Valve cover's leaking a little bit, but we're gonna call it fine. So I actually filled it up so full that it's kind of coming out the filler neck just a little bit. There's like an O-ring there. So that's not ideal. No, it's dead full. That's good. I shut it off hot. We filled it with fuel. Fired up like nothing, even though it has lots of timing in it. And it's, you know, I wouldn't say it's hot, it's actually running cool on the highway. Runs really good, this thing. Drives straight, there's no issues there. Just kind of want to make sure everything is good, but I don't think anything's rubbing against nothing. We got another 400 kilometers to go, so we did 125 or 150 miles, I don't know what it was. And yeah, I got another 250 ahead of me tonight. At the very least, we'll see how far I'm gonna go. Saskatoon is 500 miles, but again, I didn't get off work till 3:30, and then by the time we got going, it was, you know, kind of 4 something, and I'm an old man, I don't like driving at night, so. But overall, it looks good, sounds good. I do want to tape up around the steering column because a little bit of exhaust fume coming in, not terrible, but hey, we're here, we might as well do it. I'm gonna get on that.
I'll get back on the road.
Okay, 100 or so miles later. I started running a little meh, so I was stopping for some fuel, and what turns out, what had happened was, I did a little tune-up here. This plug wire, where is it? Oh, so I put the wipers on, and I knew at the time, the wiper motor was kind of touching this plug wire a little bit. It worked a little hole in it, and that caused an issue. So we did a quick wiper motor delete, And I pulled a couple plugs, just, you know, kind of because. And I, you know, I actually put a plug in that one because it was all kind of fouled up and whatnot. So we'll see if that makes a difference. We've got a bit of a coolant leak. I don't know if this is actually cracked right there. But we're going to pretend we didn't see that and just kind of carry on. The belt definitely howls when you really whip into it. But we're going to go ahead and say that's fine. I'm more than halfway, but not almost there. And the sun is starting to go down. So let's get back on the road and jam. Okay, well, I made it. We're probably, well, we're an hour or so away from where we're trying to go, or an hour and a half maybe. But I'm tired. The car's running kind of meh. It needs a set of spark plugs, which I don't have. But whoops, man, camera. So anyways, I found a Holiday Inn, and anyways, as I was coming in, that right there is my favorite restaurant. So when I went in there, she said there was one room left, and it's a twin queen suite with a pullout for way more money it's worth. I was like, oof, I do want to eat there. So I ordered myself a meal, but it's a half hour. So I figured I'd do a little bit of maintenance on this thing and clean up the car a little bit. And kind of that's it for tonight. Be back, whatever I can do tonight. I'm parked under a light here. Looks like a decent area of town. I actually don't even know. But I'll take my stuff in. Tools are locked in the trunk. We should be okay. Have a good meal. Sleep early. Be up early. Oh, screws for the wiper motor. I need those. And yeah, guys, keep on giving her. What else can you do, right? See you tomorrow. We're in. So it's, I don't know, 6:30 or something like that. Let's see if this thing will go. Oh, throttle feels weird. I'll have to investigate that real quick. We're back. Throttle cable's flipped over the carburetor for some reason. I was messing with it last night. Maybe I got in there. Oh yeah, feels good. Ooh. Yes. He's definitely snorky. Let's try and not piss everybody off. We don't have to. You know me, good neighbor. I'll be good at it. Man, this thing, she's a little cold-blooded. Okay, so we gotta find a fuel station and get the hell out of Dodge. We got a couple hours drive in front of us. I think the highway is that way. Nice if there was a gas. Oh, there's no. What do we got going on here? Surely there's gotta be something. I wasn't really paying attention when I came in last night. Yeah, we'll figure it out. Oh, right here. Nailed it. Perfect. Oh yeah. She warms right up. All right, let's get some fuel. Throw some garbage out. Oh, hit the highway. All fueled up. God, this car sounds good. So, the old GPS of the year. This is how it's due here. So, spent the night in Regina. The sound, the city that rhymes with fun. Anyway, hopefully this wants us to go, you know, wants to go right through town, which I have no interest in doing at even at 6:30 in the morning. If we go the other way, they'll take us on the ring road. Get the frig out of here. So, car ran good yesterday. Sounds good. I want to change plugs on it. The only thing that happened yesterday, the only one weird thing, it leaks well. It leaks well on the breathers, which I knew. And I tried to get some from the speed shop, and they were out of stock. And I was leaving, so that's the way that went. And it kicked on overdrive once, but I may have not been paying attention and hit it with my knee. So it is right there. So, but it kicked out. I was, kicked it back in, and there you are. But I wasn't really paying attention. Wasn't really paying attention there. And Danny, post notes, edit that out. Highway to Moose Jaw. That's on the way. So, this was as much of Regina as I want to see. Oh, construction. Huh. We can avoid some of this. 40. Oh no, this is not good. Huh. Can I get around this? Nice. Okay. Well, we're literally at the end of town. Oh, Montana's. Is there everything I need for money here? Phone, wallet, GoPro, earbuds. We're on it. Alright. We're out of here. Let's get the slice for Gina. See you on the highway. Worse there. not too long ago, when a little white knuckled me. Now, the problem is past Dan screwed over present Dan as per usual. So yesterday, we were ripping this thing and it dumped the cylinder because, and I knew it, I didn't think it would be as bad. I think it was probably as bad as it was. The white motor I put on, this white motor, was rubbing up against one of the plug wires on the cap, and I thought, the game dump is anywhere, it must be funny. So it was rubbing against the plug wire, and we lost, it's back to reading again. So we lost one cylinder, so I thought, okay, no big deal, change the plug. Put in a plug wire I had, just some generic wrong one, and remove the wiper motor, which in turn, I was like, oh, it bent. Now, we're running into this situation where she's raining. Don't worry, we're keeping her up at 75 mile an hour here, because honestly, the faster you go, these tri-fi windows just start to wick away. Overdrive all the moisture. Look at that. So right now we're going probably 60, stepping up 50 mile an hour. There you go. There's gonna work way off. So the trick to rain in a drive-five is drive faster. So hopefully it sticks kind of light-ish rain. And we have a downpour, we gotta pull over and either A, put that white motor back on to deal with the plug wire situation. Wait it out. Fortunately, I think it's supposed to be kind of sprinkly day today, so I don't know. We'll carry on, I'll keep you updated, and keep on keeping on here. I had to go to three small towns before I could find premium fuel. So, where are we going here now? Continue. So the first town was like, oh yeah, we got lots of gas. I just kind of wanted to, you know, take a break or whatever. The second town was like, oh, okay, they didn't really have anything. I was like, eh, whatever. And this one, I was like, well, we're putting in whatever they got. So we're 30 minutes. Yeah, wouldn't have been able to make it. It took a, oh yeah, it was a full fill. All right, so now it's 9 o'clock. A.M. Going to meet my buddies there. They're going to get a little breakfast. Yeah. And I got to get some spark plugs. Do a little bit of maintenance. We should be fine. So, let's keep making miles. Oh, and the rain has not stopped. I don't know if I mentioned that or not, but it's been a bit of a hassle. This thing's not happy at idle for some reason. It's idling fine, it's just not as raunchy as it was, but in RPMs, no problem. It has all the power, so play with it a little bit. Maybe, I might play the distributor down or something like that. It's not making any noise, I'm sure it's fine. Let's go on the road here. Oh, Dunder! Big birds. Got to town, had to get a few parts, so we got spark plugs, I had to buy a sweater because Danny ain't packing one, and most importantly, a new pool noodle. Everyone's asked about the pool noodle. It's when you're one man operating the foot front end, it needs it. Ooh, this thing needs bridle. Or something. Not happy. Anyways, there's a car show. I'm gonna go drop this thing off and hang out with my buddy Josh and Chris. We're gonna, or Josh and Dallas. Why is this thing not wanting to idle? Now it's like when the air filter is on, it runs bad. When the air filter's off, it runs good. Well, let's play with it. Okay. So, I'm going to modify this real quick. They're half ways. And then, split it. Now we can pop the hood, or flip the hood. See why this thing is running El Garbage-o. Let's pull this side out. I guess you can't see anything, you have to trust me. We wrap it around the fender, which actually is a pain when they're brand new. There we go. Now we can flip it without the fender getting caught on the door. Here we go. I wonder why this is affecting anything. So I just actually messed with it before I started filming. Well, did a few things, but now it's running real so lean it won't idle. Like, what the heck? Pool noodle. It needs spark plugs. Bad. It's cranky idle and deal with it. Yeah, it's gonna be what it's gonna be. Ooh, not happy. Alright, we'll just do everything John doesn't want and get to the show and deal with it. Place or not, I'm kind of winging it here. Hopefully, we can find where we're going. This poor car, it's almost embarrassing with how lame. Like, the whole point of it was to have the idle through the parking lot. Now it just sounds kind of blah. I guess that's what happens when it runs on six cylinders intermittently. So, we're going to Rods, Hot Rods. Which, I've seen this guy lots. I think it's a consignment place for old cars. So, we'll just see if they got something going on here. Leave the thing here, and we gotta do some run around, get some parts. My buddy Dallas mangled up the diff, I think, on his Mustang. So we gotta get that back together. Man, if it wasn't a gong show, it would even be fun. Oh, I think, I don't know, I guess we're in like an industrial area. I don't know this area at all. Not even a little bit. But the left radio just told me. So we'll see. Yeah, there is hot rod stuff everywhere though. Other stuff, I don't know if you guys, oh, the scoop probably blocked on that side. All the little like tire shops, everything are all having some sort of a car show and stuff. I guess this would be it right here. Oh yeah, Rods, Hot Rods. And I'm sorry guys, I've been terrible at filming. The sun's going down. I didn't know what we'd film last. But, so, you know, I was chasing things around. As you can see, I had distributor out and stuff. Basically, we went through it. I set, put the plugs, changed plugs, put a valve set, set the valve, sorry. And did that. The carburetor's leaking, which is a bit of a bummer. But we went through the whole thing and actually it runs pretty good again now. So that's pretty slick. As you can see, the thing's kind of yard sailed out here. So we're at my buddy Josh's house. I don't know how much film I'm going to get across for the next couple days here, but 55 Chevrolet, Cadillac. That's my buddy Dallas is working on 67 Mustang, which he put a mod motor in, which I'd like to do a whole video on if we can, but unfortunately it's going to be nighttime right away. So we'll give a little teaser scrap pile. Man, you're that guy.
Oh yeah, what guy?
You're that guy. Okay, you have to block all the racist stuff here because people don't like that. Not that I don't condone it here. I'm just. So, The other thing we did here, well, I didn't do any. I was very little part of this. A couple of measurements. So Dallas had the 67 Mustang, which he did this. And it's a 5-speed in it. And on the first pull, broke the factory 8-inch. So then he came up with a great idea to weld the 8-inch tubes into the center section. We're having a center section built right quick because Josh knows everybody in rural Saskatchewan. And then we're going to go try and cruise 8th Street, right? Yeah. We're still doing that tonight?
No, we're trying to go get impounded.
Yeah. As long as this car or your car looks worse than mine, I'm in the clear. Well, there you have it. So I think I'm starting to end this video. I know it's been all over the place. It's actually only been, I guess, a day. So I got off work and motored halfway or, you know, 3/4 of the way. Honestly, the car did good. You know, I mean, other than that one spark plug wire and then running the valves on it, it's been super reliable. I can't really complain. I do want to get, I hope my carburetors show up by the time I'm back, because I want to get another road trip next weekend, even further than this. But I really want the tunnel ram with the dual quads on it. I think my big issue I'm running into is carburation. Obviously, there's some stuff here and there. The valve covers leak. I mean, actually, I got to put some towels on that. There's oil leaks and stuff, but hey, that just keeps it from rusting. This XP carburetor and the one actually that I borrowed from John, which I still have and I got to return, they're great, but they're really good at wide open, full passes, like race carburetors. That's what they are, right? Versus something like this, which is a little more, you know, I guess I wanted a race car. It can easily be changed, but what this thing would need is like a 456 gear, a crazier stall, and obviously some different carburetor. Well, actually, the carburation is probably about right for it if you're gonna have an all-out race car. But I want something that kind of looks like a race car, sounds like a race car. It'll have fun. It's respectable on the street, but we can drive it to the mountains or drive it to Power Tour, whatever it is. And I think that's where this is a perfect setup. If I get those vacuum-operated, you know, vacuum secondary carburetors, get those dialed together, that'll be a little bit of tuning. Motor trans, the gear bender work trick, the 390 rear gear with the gear bender is perfect. It could maybe have a 410 actually in it, just to give it a little bit more RPM, because when we're going right at the speed limit or if there's a construction zone, you got to kind of pull it out of overdrive and you're buzzing in third gear, but overdrive's a little bit much. And that's a big part of it. It's the tire, it's a bunch of things like that. But we've made a lot of progress. And ultimately, anybody who thinks you can't drive these cars, I just did 500 miles and I got here today. We wrenched on it, wrenched on that thing. And I'm going to turn around and drive all the way back tomorrow. So I'm going to get work on Monday. So there you go. Get in your old hot rod, enjoy it, drive it, have a good time. We'll go from there. Hopefully we can do a couple videos on these other hot rods. And then I don't know what's going on tomorrow. There's a car show tonight, which we're hopefully going to make if we get that rear end in. Sun's going down. And then tomorrow's a car show in the morning, but I might be out of here pretty early. I got 8.5 hours of things go well. So I'd like to be out here by noon at the latest. Anyways, thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe below. Leave a comment. Get out there and drive your thing. And if you're the one of the people that said, you can't drive this stuff, you might be right. We're only halfway done. See you later.